Hey guys, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. Now, my goal is at the end of this video is for you guys to know more about what is a business coach and how can they help you run your business online or even as a freelancer, how you can take advantage of that. If this is your guys' first time on my channel, my name is Lacaba. I am the virtual ate. I've been working from home since I was 15 years old and now run an outsourcing company here in the Philippines. Now, our guest for today is known as the business coach for Misfits. She empowers non-conformists around the globe to create success tailored to their lifestyles. Before coaching online, she was a cross-cultural business and communications consultant who worked with executives all over the world and coached over 1,000 professionals. Within 2 years of coaching, she's been featured in HuffPost, Elephant Journal, Pick the Brain, and Addicted to Success, and was the only Asian woman featured in Money Code and How to Crack It, a book that debuted at number 14 on Amazon. Her 1,000 plus clients range from side hustlers to new entrepreneurs to new American Ivy League graduates to diplomats. One way that she helps her clients is through Worthy of More, a step-by-step guide in articulating, quantifying, and owning your worth. I will put all of her links in the description below so you guys can check out all of what our guest offers. Okay, guys, so please help me welcome the amazing Maria Kathlyn Tan. Hi, Maria!
Thank you for having me, Leanne. It's a pleasure to be here with everybody.
So excited. And I love the tagline that you also use because this is definitely something that a lot of people can identify with, being a misfit and trying to create a business in a world where there is usually some traditional sense, but they want to blow it out the window and do it themselves. So this is a very interesting topic to kind of talk with you about today. So for you, I know you have very interesting history. Like I know you started having businesses actually as young as you were 6 years old. I saw on your Instagram the other day. So how did you get started with this? I know we've talked about it a little bit for the people who are watching. How do you get you started with just having a business online or just purely working online nowadays?
So I went into online business coaching in 2017. But before that, I was already consulting with businesses, some of course through online because I specialized in cross-cultural business and communications. So market penetration, development, East-West trading. So there's already a lot of that online aspect, but not a lot of the online marketing because back then I did not do a lot of marketing at all. Most of my clients and the businesses that came to me were through word of mouth. So that that alone was enough. So when I was very depressed in my mid-20s and I just felt like something's missing in my life. And I just kept going back to what is it that I want to share with the world, right? Like, I think people underestimate what we have already in us and what has frustrated us all our lives, what has made us really question ourselves or doubt ourselves all our lives. And all those layers are what would propel us forward. So in my mid-20s, I was so confused. I really went back to what is it that made me special or different? And I kept going back to what makes me different is really being able to overcome that second-class citizen mindset and creating a new reality, right? Rising above all the limitations that's been placed upon you through your passport, gender, age, whatever, right? The color, nationality, and really create a successful empire. And I've beaten and defied odds over and over again. And I thought, you know what? It's time to teach people to do that because I was doing charity before. And how many people can you really help, right? Like, you teach people how to fish and you don't give them fish because at the end of the day, that is just a temporary solution. But if you help people or you empower people to really rise above all the limitations and then create an empire around who they are, monetize their magic, that's a lifetime, and you create that ripple effect, right? I was thinking in 2017, I just wanted to create 1 million miracles. That's it. Like, I wanted to be part of 1 million miracles. And I didn't know how to measure that then. But for me, like, every person that I come in contact with, whether it's like podcasts or my clients, the more intimate my relationship is with the person, the more impact that I give or I pay forward because by helping them, my energy changes the other person, right? It drives the other person to a different direction to see something bigger. So that alone allowed me to perform my miracles. And I thought, wow, that's me, right? My clients, in the past, actually, a lot of my clients called me Miracle Maria. And I just stayed away from that marketing because at that time, I was attracting people who were wanting the quick fix solutions. So I just decided, no, I'm not selling Maria water, you know, like miracle water. I'm selling a solution that is permanent, something that would change your foundation, something that would really allow you to move forth and push forth again all obstacles, all struggles, everything that stifles your growth. So that for me was the journey overall.
I love that you kind of really went back to where you were before and basically what kind of sparked your miracle inside of you. Like you reversed, like you looked at the mirror and like, what would, you know, that miracle look like for me? And you made it happen. And it sounds like one of the things that you do is you find that one thing, you know, that big domino that will like crash everything else that would help everyone else. So speaking of that, what do you do as a business coach for Misfits? Can you tell us a little bit more about how you're able to help these people, how you're able to be Miracle Maria, you know, helping them find that big domino that will topple everything else?
Let me ask you, since you said you identify with the word Misfits, right? What is your biggest struggle as a Misfit?
Well, for me, like for a few years there, like when I first became CEO at 20 years old, a lot of people didn't believe me, or a lot of people wanted me to prove them something so I can prove that I earned my title or some sort of that way. So I've always felt like I've had to fight against the quote unquote norm, especially when people find out that I actually never graduated college. That's why I've always kind of find my own way through the puzzle. Like I don't fit with everyone else's puzzle. I kind of can blend to it, you know, find a way that I can fit and work with the puzzle, whatever solution or problem it is faced. So that's why I kind of identify as a misfit is I've always had to fight over something or have to prove something with myself and also with other people.
So your struggle has always been proving your worth, proving that your way can be created, right? That there's no one way. So every misfit has that same problem, right? And every misfit just wants to be heard, to be seen, to be validated, to be valued, right? At the end of the day, that's what a misfit wants. Although we know we don't fit in the world, but we know that we have the right to have our own space in this world, to make our mark in this world, to claim our spot in this world. So every misfit has that underlying desire that, yes, I know I'm different, but it does not make me lower than someone else. It doesn't make me less than someone else. So there's that underlying belief or something that really, really pushes every misfit to show up, to be different, to stay true to their integrity, right? So just think that is very much the underlying belief system, the underlying trigger, the underlying motivator for most misfits. So what happens when you throw a misfit among the sea of people who are teaching business?
Well, I guess kind of like how I kind of stumbled into business. I can imagine like drowning, but you're still kicking to get yourself up to the level until you learn how to kind of just float.
Yeah, but over and over, you hear a few things. That cannot work. That cannot be. No, that's impossible, right? So like you said, you're still kicking. You still build your resilience. But again, every time that you're faced with that wall, it's always, that's not true. That's not possible. You cannot be, you cannot make money that way. That's not how business is run. You cannot be a CEO because you did not graduate. Like all of that, right? It's what's the pushback, right? It's all about, no, you cannot. And for me, with my vast experience in dealing with different kinds of businesses, I know that there are multiple ways of making business work. And a lot of times, the people who tell you that kind of business doesn't work, that kind of CEO doesn't work, it's because they have a very limited exposure to business. A lot of the times, people online, let's say business coaches, business gurus, business mentors, they created success doing something one way. So they have a very narrow road to business, right? And okay, maybe they've made money. Okay, congratulations. I don't know how long they've had that money, how they thrive, how they are able to sustain it. But I can tell you in business, if you are not adaptable enough, you cannot sustain. And sure. That is the purpose. That is the magic of being a misfit, because you know, like you said, how you don't fit into a puzzle, but you kind of like blend in, right? So for me, that's how I help my clients. First of all, by validating, yes, whatever it is that you're thinking works, even if you haven't articulated that, even if you don't know how to articulate your message yet, even if you don't know how to verbalize very, very succinctly the world that you're painting it, your vision, your values, your voice, even if you haven't identified where you are yet, even if you haven't defined your market yet, defined your business yet, whatever you have in mind that you haven't put into words, that works. That's it. The first thing is very important. That works. That's a possibility. So together, we'll just bridge those gaps, right? Bridge those pieces. Second would be, okay, which of the things do you like and which don't you like? In business, there are so many ways to make money, so many ways to run a business. So which aspects do you like and don't like? And that, from there, we filter. It's pretty much the more aware you are about yourself, the better it is for you to run a business, because you will not be distracted doing things that do not resonate with you.
Oh, so I love that you start with validation. You're kind of telling them like, your way can work. You might not have everything figured out, but it's something, basically own it, own this path that you are now paving for yourself. And like, I can see like for me, I was lucky that I had a mentor right on the get-go, but I can see like if 5 years ago, me didn't have that mentor, like didn't have my boss who was also a misfit, he found his own way through life, I would have felt lost and invalidated, and I would have probably just tried to fit in some place that I didn't even want to go to. And I love that you really try to highlight their strengths, because a lot of the time as misfits, we try to have someone else's strengths, not focusing on our own, what we already have. So that gives someone who is a misfit.
I think a lot of the time with all this positivity, the self-development era, I think a lot of the time people focus too much on working on themselves versus highlighting what already makes them special.
That's such a common thing that I see. I've never thought of it that way. That's super interesting. And like I said, I love that this is what you do, because it's for a lot of, especially like, you know, my generation of millennials, we have TED Talks, we have a lot of gurus and coaches out there who teach us the right things, but a lot of them doesn't really work on what do you already have, and let's just strengthen that instead of like, what are the things that your weaknesses and like work on your weaknesses. It's more of highlighting that strength, highlighting that thing that they already like doing and working and growing in that. So it's amazing. So far, like in the last 3 years that you have been someone who's been working with a bunch of misfits, what has been the most surprising thing about that?
I think I'm always awed by how fast growth is. You know, I know I'm part of the whole thing, right? But still, it's so magical to see a person like, for me, it's so easy to know if a person changed or evolved or just, you know, it's like came out of their shell. Just from the way they talk, just from the way they show up on Instagram or on social media. And people have this belief that visibility is about consistency, it's about how much you post. But honestly, visibility is how consistent you are with your energy. It's not about the number of times you post. It's not the algorithm, because all of that will follow, right? Mm-hmm. Like what would sell is our energy. People will connect to that. It's not the number of posts that you make in a day, right? It's how you show up as a leader. It's how you show up as the misfit, as the difference. And I always tell people, you have to really own your difference to make a difference. So for me, it's that kind of journey or that unlayering that really always surprises me in a very good way. And sometimes it brings me to tears, because, you know, it's like magic and beauty happening just in front of you, right? It's like a butterfly just coming out of the cocoon. It's beautiful. So for me, again, yes, I know my process works. Yes, I know I'm part of the whole thing. But to see that and to witness that, that's magical. And for me, the biggest signs are always when my clients challenge me. I like it because it means they are empowered enough to say, no, that's not what I meant. This is what I meant. And I can be very passionate about, you know, about things. So when this person just comes and say, no, I don't like to do that. No, I don't agree. That means this person is empowered. And a lot of coaches and gurus actually don't like being questioned or being challenged. For me, I don't agree because only an empowered person would say those questions, right? A disempowered person would just follow the flock. But for someone who's really stepped into their own shoes and stepped into their own magic, they can say, no, this is not who I am. No, I don't agree with that. Hold on, I don't understand what you're saying. Can you say that again? Like, or I cannot understand it, whatever you're saying, right? So for me, I like it. So for me, just from the way a person talks, it's so easy for me to know how much this person now is capable of making. Mm-hmm. Because it's so easy to, again, it's so easy to know how much she's capable of bringing in terms of income, in terms of sales, because people who are so certain of what they offer have a bigger capacity for receiving money and receiving business, right? People who are less confident about who they are will have a smaller window for that opportunity. Mm-hmm.
That's true. I love that you use the word off, because not a lot of people really use that word of seeing someone grow. Like as recently as this morning, one of my own clients is shining. She just got promoted from like everything that she's been doing, and I love seeing that. So I love that you use, again, the word obvious. It's not used a lot. And also at the same time, I love that you mentioned like stepping into knowing their boundaries, knowing what they can do, what they want to push against, not even what they can't do, but what they want to push against and ask and challenge you. I love it that you said, I love it when they challenge me, because that shows that their growth, that shows that they're not just going to do whatever it is that you told them to do. They want to test things. They want to do things for themselves. And I think that's very interesting that you've done this long enough that you've seen that happen over and over. So with that, like if someone out there wants to also become a business coach, for example, or you want to talk to Marie of 3 years ago, what would be a shortcut or what would be a piece of advice that you would give to someone who wants to start doing this online? Or again, if you were talking to Marie of 3 years ago, what would be a piece of advice for someone getting started?
Sell what you know. Mm-hmm. Because at the end of the day, you cannot sell something that you don't know. Meaning, I think it's normal to be distracted by so many things online. Mm-hmm. But once you try to become who you're not, you cannot sell. So sell what you know.
True. You have to start kind of like what you said, the way that you start with their strengths, you start with what already is your strength, and you can build up from there. That is awesome. So for now, what has been your focus? What has been, like, I'll call it different ways. Like, what is your big, hairy, audacious goal? Or what's something that you're working towards as a business coach, helping a lot of the amazing misfits out there? What is your big, hairy, audacious goal? What are you working towards?
So I think when you say, what am I working towards? It's really just scaling what I'm doing. Because mm-hmm. I've found what I wanted to do. I know everything is going to succeed. And I know things are just happening at a certain timeline or timing. So for me, it's more of scaling more sustainably. So, and not rushing the process. I think that's the biggest blind spot for people, to rush things when things are not ready yet. So it's just that, like, scaling sustainably.
So with that, like, for those who are watching, for those who is a misfit and clicked on this YouTube video because they want to learn more, they want to grow more, how can they reach you? How can they find you? What are the programs or the things that you are currently doing to kind of catch all and make sure that they can get started themselves?
So the first thing that I'm really, really am visible in is Instagram. So you can see me there. It's my second home. I share a lot of you know, behind the scenes there. I share a lot of my, what I believe in there. So you, it's curated as well. I love it because the feed shows all the things that I believe in. The IGTV shows me, the stories are there. I'm waiting for reels to come here in Manila. And so all of that, I'm just there. So pretty much you see a multidimensional me there. So that's where you can find me more. I think if you want to really get started, okay, so the one thing that I would suggest is Worthy of More, because Worthy of More is a program, it's a digital course that really walks you through quantifying, articulating, and owning your worth. And I know that people always say, where do I start? And I will tell you, you start with you, honestly. Mm-hmm. You start with you, you start with really acknowledging your worth, really seeing who you are. Because I've seen a lot of people go for certificates. When clients hire you, they don't really care what certificates you have, right? Like, people don't come to you and say, hey, can I see your certificate? Nobody does that. So for me, like, really, really knowing yourself, you start with yourself. You start with really understanding your worth, really verbalizing it, at least to yourself. And a lot of times people cannot, they cannot articulate who they are even. So for me, you start with you. So that's the first one, Worthy of More. I have a membership community that just opened. It's called the CEO Circle. This is for people who want the community of like-minded. I call it like-minded, purpose-driven, visionaries, idealists, non-conformists, multi-passionate creatives. So that is an ongoing membership. So if that's one thing that you want, it's very, very atypical. It's not the normal mastermind or group coaching program, because I don't want me to be on the pedestal. I just want to provide a space for people to be seen, be heard, be respected. And we have, it's mostly like 80% me facilitating the space and 20% me coaching. So we have coaching Saturdays, but it's pretty much really for you to collaborate, to connect, to celebrate each other. And we have a monthly roundtable workshop session where we really get to discuss topics in business, because you need to be trained to communicate and express yourself and express your difference, because that's what CEOs do. And I think when you see the mastermind groups, there's really a lot of the coach just being put on the pedestal, and a lot of like laser coaching style. And in as much as it's great to listen to everybody's struggles, you want to be heard too. So for me, it's the most important part. Let's not waste our time. It's really for you to just be seen. So that's if you're at a level where you feel, you know, you're ready, you know yourself, or you want to be learning with other people, then that's the way to go. But again, for me, if you want to get started, I would start with worth, because worth is something that people cannot take away from you. It's pandemic proof. It's trend proof. So it's something that you can articulate yourself. It's an asset that only grows in time.
I love that you start with that, because I just said this the other day. You are your longest relationship. You're literally going to be, you know, you said it's pandemic proof. It's also relationship proof. It's also like money proof. Like, whether you're rich or you're poor, this is still you. So it's better to just kind of get to know yourself in that way. And if you guys are interested in that, I'll put all of the links below. So any last words, Maria, any parting like advice for anyone who does want to check out your program or does want to get themselves started having a business for themselves?
There's no need to rush when you know where you're going.
Very wise words, and I love that. Because I know for a lot of people who are starting out, they want to rush and want everything right off the bat overnight sometimes. So thank you for that. So thank you so much, Maria, for giving your time, for giving a lot of your advice, of a lot of your wisdom in the last couple of years. And I hope a lot of you guys taking notes are taking action next steps for you guys. And thank you so much again, Maria, for being here.
You're welcome. Pleasure.
Like I said, guys, all of the links for Maria can be found below, all of her Facebook, her Instagram, and also, like I mentioned, her program, Worthy of More. You guys can check it out below. And if you're interested in her membership site, I can also put the link below if you guys want to check it out. Now, make sure to leave a like if you guys got any amazing insights from Maria today. And of course, leave a comment, any favorite takeaways, and every favorite like pieces of advice that she has given, because she has given a lot of nuggets of gold for you guys today. And I hope you guys picked up on a lot of them. Now, if you guys haven't yet, make sure to hit subscribe button right there so you don't miss any of my videos every Sunday and Thursday on how to work from home. And if you guys can, please share this video on your Facebook page to reach us more people. Now you guys can check out these other two interviews right here so you guys can learn more from other experts that I've had on this channel. I hope you guys have an awesome day, and remember that small steps matters, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!